Sao Paulo.
Yeah.
And here's the kit. It's pretty. Got some DW Collector Series today. And I am getting a tour shirt now, which is very nice. Look at that.
And guess who the actor is?
Paul Gilberto.
Paulo Gilberto.
And my friend Daniel is here.
Hello.
Yeah, this is Daniel Gon from Brazil. We just sound checked that it's all sounding good. And what's happening now, Daniel? What are we doing?
Food.
Food. Tommy does one day of fasting a week. One day of only liquids.
And guess what day today is?
Yep, today's liquid day.
That day.
Jeff,
yes.
Fill me in on what's happening.
We've got chicken dinners on the way.
Chicken dinner?
Yeah.
Woo!
And no smoke, no strobes.
That's true. That's our only one stipulation at every show. We don't like the smoke and we don't like the strobes. Yeah. These are egg slicers.
They are egg slicers, so, yes. For tuna salad.
For
only,
tuna though. Salad. Do you sometimes use them for just egg salad, plain egg salad too?
Sometimes they just rub mayonnaise all over it.
Yeah,
miracle whip,
exactly.
If we have it.
It helps Paul with his speed, right? With
yeah.
the finger, the slippery,
the
greasy.
Whip.
Miracle whip.
Hence the word miracle whip.
Exactly. and that's Paul's secret to the super fast licks.
Yeah.
Jeff here preps his guitars with mayonnaise before the show.
Yeah.
Sometimes olive oil.
Sometimes butter.
And or just plain butter.
Or salted, margarine if they have
salted
it.
Salted or unsalted?
Salted.
Salted.
Yeah.
It's more, a little more spicy,
yeah,
a little
yeah.
more savory.
Yeah.
So that's the sound, you know, that Paul gets. And if you want to be like Paul?
Miracle Whip.
Miracle Whip.
Butter.
Butter. Salted. And mayonnaise.
And then throw some vinegar in. Just
why not throw some vinegar in?
At this point, you know.
Exactly. And then you can shred Scarify just like Paul. You know, no more technical difficulties. You know? Brazil, in Sao Paulo at the moment, that's what it looks like. I wasn't able to film all the shows so far, it's been really busy. It's beautiful here, the fans have been amazing. I'll show you a different view from these windows. There is Sao Paulo, look at it. The shows have been great, the weather is amazing, the food has been amazing. Of course, we went to a great churrascaria the first night we arrived here. Really excellent. And today, I have a drum clinic here in Sao Paulo. We're going to have a very short night because tomorrow morning we fly to Chile at 5 in the morning. John,
hey
there.
What's up?
I'm filming for my tour blog. This is John, and this is his beautiful studio right here, and this is where the clinic is happening tonight. we're in Buenos Aires. These are my drums today. We have to speak very quietly. Why? I'm not telling you. This finish is called Sunburst, I think. Or it's a tobacco to natural fade, maybe? That's the thing. When you're on a rock and roll tour, there's a lot of screaming and shouting, so we have to preserve our voices. So in the daytime, we speak very quietly like this. We whisper to each other, mostly. Pete is a total bass amp nerd. He's taking pictures of the settings, and then he looks at them later in the hotel when he's alone. He's a weirdo.
It's more improving what an amp shouldn't have to do to sound
excuses,
good.
Excuses.
Yeah, that night.
He looks at them later.
And I think dirty thoughts.
And then he zooms into them. And he looks at the numbers, go, oh, it's at 5.
Oh, the mid-range.
Oh, and you know what? These don't even go to 11.
That was shite.
Yes. Shite. We get rid of the shite. Oh man, is that the loop for the night?
Ooh. Dinner's on daddy over
Rico. Ah, oh, look at you. Yeah, come on. Oh yeah, rock and roll.
Take it off.
So we're in La Boca, in Buenos Aires. This is what it looks like.
La Boca Juniors, the football team, they've been the champion last season. Yeah, we're checking out the stadium and some other stuff and some hookers.
That's right. Magnets.
Yes.
Look at that. Important. I'm going for the
Gilbert.
Yeah.
¿Quieres tomar algo, muchachos?
No, gracias.
Cuando guste.
Oh, look at them dance. That's nice. In Uruguay, in Montevideo, and this is what it looks like.
Bring the beat back. That's right.
This is how we do. This is how
That's
we
right.
do.
Another day, another skyline. Boom. We played in where were we yesterday? We played in Argentina. We played in Buenos Aires last night and the night before. We did two shows in Buenos Aires, and before that we were in Santiago, Chile, and before that we were in Brazil. It's been a little stressful. We've had super early lobby calls, and I mean really early. And it'll go on like this for the rest of the tour, because tomorrow, for example, we have a 3 a.m. lobby call. Yeah, us! Good times, lots of traveling, because we're flying and sound checking and playing every day, so you can imagine there's not much downtime. And I've caught a cold. You may be able to hear this. My nose is all stuffy. So that's what's happening right here. And the AC is blowing at my back right now, and I have to turn that off.
Did a gig in Venezuela from the airport to the hotel. 3 hours of horrible traffic.
And then we had one of these wake-up calls, you know, 3 a.m. lobby things. So there was no traffic at night, which was great. We're like, right on, you know, nobody's on the road. And I think some Venezuela drivers got so excited that there was no traffic that they went a little quick. They flipped over and their cars caught on fire.
Oh.
Two different, that we saw saw one like that. It's pretty rare, exceptional, that you see a car upside down on
fire. Not so often.
But so we sort of went by because there's lots of room, because no traffic. And then like 20 minutes later, there's another one.
Oh.
I thought, is this just an average night in Venezuela? You know, two upside down cars on fire?
Right.
I mean, in my 20 years of living in LA, I have seen that once.
Right.
But I was only in Venezuela for one night.
Exactly. You know, so perfectly normal.
I have to go back and find out.
Well, let's hope we're not upside down on fire in a minute.
I've noticed the funny thing about guitar cases and hotels is Pablo's fine, but like people that work for hotels, it's their job to be like the bell person.
Right.
And they're obviously trying to take good care. Like, they don't want to break the guitar.
Exactly.
And they're really careful, and they always put it in the most precarious position, like
on the roof, no straps.
Very carefully putting it somewhere in the place, it's definitely gonna fall.
Okay.
Hi.
Hi.
Here in Montevideo.
Hola.
Tonight, yeah.
Todo bien?
Todo lindo.
surprise song for you right now. Even Pete and Thomas didn't know about this one. I just decided to play it. Very, very good.